I'm telling them about love, all-pervading love of God Almighty. He has created this whole thing. The whole atmosphere is there. The whole feeling is there of love. But it's possible only for people who are innocent, like children. If you are very matured in your hatred, no one can save you. You will have 10 arguments to show that your hatred is justified. Then you go to any extent to justify it. We had people in our country, which is supposed to be a very sober country, a very peaceful country. We had people who just believe in killing. Kill this, kill that. So even in this country, which didn't believe in all these things, indulged into all kinds of violence since long. But basically, we are people who believe in peace. Because without peace, no growth can take place. There has to be complete peace. If there is peace in your heart, if there is peace surrounding you, you grow into a beautiful nation. Not out of fear, not out of pressure, but from inside, if you are a person who has complete peace within the heart, not that he is not afraid of anything, but he emits peace. He gives peace. Anybody who goes near such a person gets the peace, the feeling of peaceful. You all are Sahaja Yogis. You all have got your realization. That is, your spirit is now emitting vibrations of peace and joy. Wherever you are, you will emit peaceful vibrations. You will create peace. You will find out ways of creating peace, how to establish peaceful atmosphere. It's very important that we have to grow in such a manner that we create peace and give peace to others and become examples of it. I cannot believe in this Delhi, I could have so many people who are realized. I never expected. First of all, I had to wait till people got into a proper mind to understand my work. Because we had partition and so many people lost their lives, lost their properties. And I have faced all that, I have seen it myself. And they just couldn't forgive other people. So forgiveness is a very good method of understanding the pain of others, troubles of others. But this depth you have to develop. Instead of getting angry, getting revengeful, if you can develop that peace within yourself, if you can manage to have the peace of your mind through divine love, there's no need for you to do anything extra. It's just the peace that you have now in your heart. Just feel it. You are a peaceful person. You are not a person who is easily disturbed. You will never give explanations for getting angry, for spoiling the mood of people. You will not do. You are the one who rises above all this anger and this stupid revengefulness. It is difficult to explain to those people who are not realized. Because if I talk to them, they won't like it. If they get their realization, we can talk to them. So best thing is you should spread Sadhu. Spread them among Sikhs, among Muslims, among Christians, throughout, and especially among Hindus. Because nowadays I find Hindus are also have lost their grip over their understanding of our country and its culture. And that's how they just revenge, they take revenge. I don't understand this kind of revenge. But what to do? People are already on that level, on that low level, where they don't understand many things. For example, now they do not want people to build a temple of Sri Rama at a particular point. Because they are not Sahajyogis, I can't talk to them that that is the place where he was born. So we must pay full respect to his incarnation. If that is the place he was born, we can feel it with the vibrations, then why deny the fact and the truth just because you don't want it to be done? It's very difficult to talk to them. What to understand is that what has Babar done for us? Who was Babar? He was a foreigner. And this one not even was built by Babar. No, it was not. It was somebody who was his, one of the military man who went and built it. And that's why they call it a Babri Masjid. But let us find out what happened to this Mr. Babar. He died, but he came from abroad. He was not even an Indian. And doesn't matter, he was not born there. I mean, he had nothing to do with that place. But definitely, I know, and you all will know, can feel it on your hands just now, that it is Babri Masjid is the place where Sri Rama was born. Now, if you want to build a temple there, what will go wrong with people? What will happen to them if a temple is built there? I mean, it is just a question of respect and feelings about it. I also take Rama's name. Everybody takes his name because such a solace and such a comfort. But the way people look at things, it's difficult. You can't talk to them. Now they are talking about another nonsense that we have one hair of Muhammad Sahib in Kashmir. Now somebody said that it is not his hair. How do you know? What is your criteria to decide whose hair it is? Actually, you will be amazed, when I went to Kashmir, we were going somewhere in the car and suddenly I felt tremendous vibration. So I asked the driver, why don't you take the car on this side? He said, why? Because I want to. He said, it's an old road and there are some few people living there, doesn't matter, take it. We went near and nearer, and there were some houses of Muslims. So we called them and asked them, what is here going on? They said, it is Hazrat Bal. Even the name gives you such peace. It was the hair of Muhammad. Now, Hindus don't want to know about him. And Muslims don't want to know about Sri Ram. It's very surprising. They all are having their own shops and selling their own things. But they don't understand that whatever they are selling is the same which the other people are selling. For example, they say Allah. Who is Allah? According to Sahajyog, Allah is nobody else but Vishnu. And Vishnu, who came also as Sri Ram. So, whatever they call as Allah is Sri Ram himself. Only a Sahajyogi can understand. If you put up your hands now when I am talking, you will be surprised what vibrations are. Because it is Sri Ram who is Allah, whom you are trying to insult by your stupidity. So it could be stupidity on part of Muhammad Sahib or on part of Hindus. Hindus are also not understanding. Somehow they know that that is the birthplace of Sri Ram. Somehow, I don't know, somebody must have told them. Or maybe, I don't know how they know, they don't know vibrations. I haven't yet met many Hindus who have vibrations. I mean, those who are what you can call fundamentalists. They never have vibrations. So I used to wonder, how do they know this is the Janmabhoomi of Sri Rama? Maybe, somehow they come to know. But they have no point to prove. The problem is, if they were realized souls, if our high court judges were realized souls, if our cabinet was realized souls, you could have talked to them. But they are all, what should I say, absolutely blocked people. How to tell them that this quarrel is a nonsense? It is perfectly all right to build a temple of Sri Ram. But whatever you may say, the trouble is, first, they all should get their self-realization. Just now, at the time when we are talking, see, there are not sufficient people who have got self-realization. We are all realized souls. There was another one who told me, who was giving realization to these Mahantas. Mahantas are the people who are supposed to be saints. And every one of them, when they got realization, they got exposed. So, he didn't know what to do with them. That may happen with anyone, even in Christian churches, or you go to Jews, this thing, everywhere you will find this is the problem. If you give them realization, they will get exposed. So, what's the use of disturbing all the people who have such faith in them and think they are very great people? Now, only way you can judge them is through vibration. But out of love, I can't tell them that you are not realized souls. You have no business to talk about Sri Ram or about Muhammad. They are much beyond. So, the problem now is between the people who are not knowledgeable and those who are knowledgeable. It was a very big gap before. Only one person used to be a realized. So they used to stone him, beat him, do all kinds of things. Now you are so many. So, if you put up your case anywhere, even at this stage, nobody is going to listen to you. I would request you only one thing. Give realization to people, as many as possible. And not to any spiritual so-called people. Because they get exposed, what's the use? This is a common thing. So many people have told me, ki, we gave realization to one priest, he got exposed. Is what happened? He was exposed, mother, he was put in jail. Huh? This is too much. After getting realization, he goes to jail. So this is the problem. He love you cannot be hypocritical about. Love you have to be a pure personality. Just try to purify yourself. You have to change. If you are still angry, if you are still greedy, if you have all these things, love won't work out. It won't work out. So to love someone in a divine way is to first understand the value of innocence. Why I love children? Because they are innocent. They don't have all these things. Like in our country these days, the epidemic of corruption has started. Epidemic. It's not simple. Anybody you see after every third person, there's an epidemic of corruption. Now, why? Because they want money. All right. Then, what do they do with their money? They don't know how to hide. So they put it in some sort of a pot or whatever it is, and the money gets lost. If not, they are caught up. That's not so important. What's important is, why have this greed? People who are rich are more greedy than the people who are poor. Because the poor people at least have some fear of God. But the rich are very greedy. They are running after this, running after that. There's no end to it. It is very surprising that in this country of ours, this new disease has started. With this disease, even in Sahaja Yoga, there are some people who have made a business out of Sahaja Yoga and making money. So greed is something that comes to you from the right side and you start justifying. There's no place for love for the right side. Now this greed has gone so far that the whole country is getting ruined. We can never progress. We can never achieve anything. Because everywhere there's greed when people are just taking. But if you love your country, if you have love for your country, you won't. But that love is missing. They love, I don't know whom do they love. They love their children in such a way that they ruin their lives. Love is not limited. Love has to be unlimited. Unlimited love which binds the whole world. There is this force. There is already acting this force. Only thing you have to become the agents of that. To become the people who can communicate that love. You have every right to that great wealth of love. And you can spread that all along. But I find that even here, people think in the terms of money. Money is the enemy of love. I assure you, if you have interest in money, you can never progress in such a way. I'm hopeless, I agree. I don't know how to take interest in it. What is so interesting about it? And people laugh at me that you don't know simple things, even to count the money. I said, I know. I can tell you like this, how much money is there. But I'm not interested. There's so many other things to be interested. You see the children, you see nice people. In the whole world, there are so many beautiful people, beautiful things. Why pay so much attention to this useless stuff which comes and goes? But that is what is the most, I should say, gripping thing it also there. In India is the worst. I think they say that India is the most corrupt country. I don't know, I have never seen that kind of thing, but must be true. On such a occasion, it's very auspicious that you should think that money is of no value, has no value. And you will be amazed, you will have never dearth of money. Absolutely. This is one thing in Sahaja Yoga you have to get. That money is of no value. There's no interest in money. Your money is in getting how many people you have in Sahaja Yoga, how many people you have brought in Sahaja Yoga, how many people have got this joy. You have not purchased it. Nobody has to purchase. It's free, flowing everywhere. It's so joy-giving. What else do you want with money? Nothing. Just with money, headaches, fear, and all kinds of problems. So, parallel to our Sahaja Yoga, it should be the life of freedom, complete freedom and enjoyment. Nothing to worry. Nothing is dependent on one. I've seen people living in very poor conditions, extremely happy and joyful. While those who have lots of money, especially in the foreign countries, are rich people, they have depression, all kinds of funny situations. They commit suicides. Why? If money was everything, why all the rich country people commit suicide? What is the gain they have? See, and all the time, what they are thinking, how to get into a kind of a fashion, or because if you have no money, you cannot get into those fashions. The fashions are so common now, so common, that for that people hanker. If they cannot get to the fashions, they think something has gone wrong with them, something is. But not you, because you are surgeons. Now you see these things happening, so what have you to do? Have pity for such people. No contempt, but pity. And you have to tell them that what are you doing? Why are you wasting your time? This is the best time for you to reach the highest goal of your life, of self-realization. And why are you so much running after all these things? What is it that makes you run this rat race? I think it's a breaking point everywhere. And people are thinking, but you are the people who should provide. In a very large scale, you can work it out. I mean, I have seen people who have nothing in them. They are not spiritual, they are not the ones who can give realization or anything. But just because they are doing some social work, they are very famous. What is the social work? Looking after the poor or something like that. Now, when your love, which is so great, which is so effective, that starts working, you feel you should do something, then you will be amazed how your Sahaja Yoga will be understood. So far, Sahaja Yoga is all right, people are very nice, excellent, saintly, you know. But effect of that must be seen, and people should see the effect of that of your love. First is forgiveness. You have to forgive me. They are utterly stupid. I have just now explained to you how stupid they are. So, nothing to worry about that. If you are such a wise personality, you should try to judge everything with wisdom. And don't fall a trap into things where you feel that you have to do it, like some fashion or some sort of some grouping. No need. We are sadhus. We are self-sufficient. We don't need anything. If you are one, we are all right. If you are many, we are all right. Now you must know that you have reached a very high state. And you have touched that love, that universal love of God. So express more of that love in your daily life. Express more of that love in dealing with others. Express your love in a way that others are made happy. It's all something to be thought. How can you quarrel if you are real Sahajyogis? How can you put down others if you are Sahajyogis? How can you deceive others if you are Sahajyogis? Not possible. Should have no interest in all this. That means now you are clarified and you are clear. And you are now Nirmal. Nobody can touch. This sort of attitude should have respect for us. This kind of understanding you should have about us. What is your role? What is your position? Should know that you are realized source, and what you should do as realized soul, that you should do. You are not another sort of madman running the rat race, or also you are not in competition. You are not competitive. You are just progressing by your own love and blessings. I know how the blessings work. But first of all, you have to be worthy of that blessing. Otherwise, can't help it. Your loving nature. That's why Christ has said that you have to be like children to enter into the kingdom of God. You are already in the kingdom of God. But you have to be like children. How innocent they are. How simple they are. And they are happy with small, small things. They don't want something very extraordinary. It's very surprising how our love, which is actually is enlightened by divine love, can change the whole world. How I had this idea and how it has prospered. If you all help me in this, I am sure Sahajyoga can do so many things which have not been achieved. Now you go home and think whatever I have told you. Think about it. What you need is introspection. What you need is understanding. What have I done out of my life as Sahajyogis? And then you will find out that you can do a lot, and that has to be done. May God bless you.